list. Any changes that need to be made, please let Stephen know. And all I've left to say is to you, Happy Christmas, everybody, from Santa. And now I'll get Santa's helper up to get the rest of the syrup.
I definitely feel... How do you follow that? Hold on, my lights aren't on. I'll try some. What's wrong with my lights now? Look at that, there's a disappointment. I definitely feel like Santa's little helper. There's no doubt about that. Good morning, folks. And I'm going to try the same again. George said Happy Christmas from Santa, and I don't think you're all sleeping. Happy Christmas, folks.
Happy Christmas.
That's better. It's really good to see you all out today. It's good to come out, especially today, to celebrate this very special day. It's good to gather as God's family. We might be thinking about that a little bit later on, but it's good to come together as God's family to worship Him, especially on a day like today. Good morning, Catherine. His grand is Santa, is he? You scared of him? Big suit? Not surprised. I'm a bit scared of him too. Folks, first, before we sing our first piece of praise, can I just take a moment and thank all who sent cards, presents, and good wishes to the manse. We do appreciate it. It's been a funny old year, I think, all around. As George says, it's good to be actually back with everybody in the church. Just sitting thinking this morning, and the first Christmas I was here, we were in the hall. Second year, we were locked down. Last year, we were socially distanced. So it's really good to have everybody back together again, and we do trust we will know God's blessing as we meet together here today. But we're going to stand, we're going to sing our first piece of praise together. O come, all ye faithful. Let's stand and let's worship God together.
Oh, God, you faithful.
Let's just pause and let's commit our time of worship to God. Let's pray together. Father, it is good to gather here together today, especially on today, such a special day, to praise and to worship you, Father. We thank you for that sense of joy that today brings us, Lord, as we celebrate the birth of Jesus into this world. Father, we thank you for your love for us that sent that little baby down to this earth, the baby that would grow into the man Jesus, to live and experience the same things that we would in this world, yet be sinless. The man who would go to the cross for our sins, that we might know salvation, and of course that we might become part of your eternal family. Father, we thank you for that sense of family that we have. Lord, today is a day where we know that sense of family as we gather together as families to enjoy the celebrations today. And Father, we thank you for that sense of family we have too, together here as your people. Lord, we pray that as we spend time worshiping you here, that we would know that sense of family and blessing of being part of your church family here. Lord, we pray that that would indeed help us and enthuse us in all things. Yet, Father, as we meet, yes, with that sense of joy in our hearts, Lord, we know this is a time of year which brings sadness and remembrance to many. Lord, we pray that even today, those who grieve the loss of a loved one, those who know that, well, we use that phrase, the empty chair, at times like these, Lord, we pray they would know something of your help, your strength, and your comfort. And Lord, we pray especially today for Jacqueline Hamilton. Lord, we know how difficult it is, Lord, any time of bereavement, but to lay your mother to rest, Lord, 2 days before Christmas, Lord, we know how difficult that is. Lord, we grieve the loss of another one of our congregation. Lord, we pray for your blessing on that family. Will you uplift them at this difficult time? Lord, we pray for all who know that. And Lord, pray that they would know you with them today. But Lord, as we gather once again as your family, we pray that you would help us and enthuse us and inspire us in all that we seek to do here, that you might receive the praise, honour and glory that is rightfully yours. And we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I'm going to turn to God's word for a moment or two. I just want to read the kind of traditional passage for this morning. I'm going to turn to Luke's Gospel, chapter 2, and read verses 1 through to 7. Of course, it is the birth of Jesus. Let's listen to God's word. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up to the town of Nazareth in Galilee, to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him, and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. Amen. We thank God for his word, and we do trust we will know the blessing of God and his word to us on a day like today. We're going to stand, we're going to sing our next piece of praise together. Love came down at Christmas. Love all lovely, love divine. Let's stand and let's worship God together. Technology's brilliant, isn't it? Completely lost there. Hang fire. Back up a wee bit. As we always do, I want us to take a few moments just to stand up, move about a wee bit, take 5 minutes just and speak to those around you and wish them a happy Christmas. And then after that, whenever I give a shout, if all the young folk want to come up and join Santa at the front here, we might even plunk them in a chair out the front, you never know. But listen, please take time, just stand up, mill about, turn around to the one behind you, wish them a happy Christmas and all the rest. It's good to do that. So. That's a good one. She's away running. Did you get a unicorn? What's this? What's that do?
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, folks, can we run back to your seats?
Oh.
Good morning. I've been told to get everybody back to their seats because George is sweating in his big suit. I don't know how he's sweating when it's blowing air in around him, like, but it's warm. It's warm. I know I was saying it's been kind of four Christmases here, and it has taken him 4 years to actually compete with me. So it'll be good to see you next year, to see where we go next year. I mean, we're lifting the level every year. Folks, I just want to take a couple of minutes. I was going to bring the young folk up around the front, but we've been around. Hopefully, I'll get down that aisle in a wee minute. But I want to just to pause and to think about a couple of things, just for a few moments. I know I did say to somebody yesterday that I would be short today and you'd be out for 11, but you all know as well as I do that that's never going to happen. But I promise it will be short. I just want to take a look. If you know that this past few years, we've taken a look at different adverts on TV. And I think last year we looked at the McDonald's advert about the, was it Imaginary Iggy, I think they called the little blue toy, that the little girl loved this toy all throughout her life. It was there by her side, helping her through all the difficult times. And then as she grew up, she threw it away in the cupboard. And I think there's always something we can learn from these adverts. Of course, they are out there in the secular world, but I think there's always an underlying message that we can take from it this Christmas. Whether the advertisers actually mean that or not, I doubt it, but I think it's good to think about these things. So I'm going to play the McDonald's advert this year. I'm not sponsored by McDonald's or anything, honestly. But I'm sure we have seen, it's called The List. I'm sure we've all seen it on our TVs over this past few weeks and so on, about the little boy who writes the big Christmas list. I'm going to play it on the screen and then a few thoughts from it just, and then I promise you, you'll get your turkey dinner after that. You're probably not eating your turkey dinner at 2 or 3 o'clock anyway, sir. So. So this is the one Sunday that your dinner won't be burnt by the time the minister stops talking. Let's go for it.
Why don't you make a Christmas list?
A list? Looking from a window above, it's like a story of love. Can you hear me? Came back only yesterday. I'm moving further.
Right, who got the underlying message? Let me give you my message. First of all, who made a Christmas list this year? Only two people. Was it as big and long as the boy in the advert, was it? No, it wasn't. That was some list, wasn't it? Imagine getting all the things on that list. But of course, the central message of the advert wasn't the big long list, And of course, we all know, we've talked about it for a few Sundays here already, we can so easily get caught up in all of that and write these big lists about all the things that we want for Christmas and all the things that we're going to do over Christmas, and we get caught up in all the commercialism of it. But I think that's a really good advert to take us away from that, because that first list is that kind of sense, isn't it? That's what society really sees Christmas about. It's just this list of things that we want, that we think we need, and all the rest of it. But of course, as the wind gets a hold of the list and takes it away, little boy's only left with one thing. And it is really only the one thing that he actually does need. We might want all these different things on the list, but there is one thing on the list is the thing that he really does need. And the most important thing at the centre of it all was his family, wasn't it? Not the big giant McMuffin he had when he was in McDonald's or whatever. I was across the town early yesterday morning and McDonald's was the only place open. And I was really tempted to go into it, but there's all these people sitting with their big McMuffins and the smell of it coming out was so tempting. But the advert's not about the McMuffin, sure it's not. It's about having family at the centre of Christmas. And we've already alluded to that, haven't we, this morning already, about gathering as God's family. And of course, there is only the one thing that makes us God's family, and that is Jesus coming at Christmas. That is the central message, that Christmas is about God and God's family. And I think one of the things that I said last year about the advert was there was this kind of underlying message in the music that's being played in the background. And of course, that one's no different. Anybody pick up the song, or are you too busy watching the big list flying up? Anybody pick up the song? Yep. And what's the words of it? All I needed was the love you gave. Now, is that appropriate? Is that an underlying message for this time of year? Of course, I think it is. All we need for Christmas is the love you gave. Does that not remind us about God's love coming down to this earth as this baby Jesus at Christmas time? And that really is the only thing that we need in this world. There's lots of things we would like. There's lots of things we can do with. There's lots of things that are useful to us. And of course, all the different toys and all the rest of it we've seen today, that as I went round there and disappointed over in this corner that there's a Massey corner, not a John Deere corner. But all these things are all well and good. But at the centre of Christmas is the love of God, isn't it? And that is all we need at Christmas. It's all we need in life is the love of God through Jesus. God loved us so much that he sent his son into the world that we might know, as we said in our prayers, that wonder of salvation, that wonder of eternal life, that we might know our sins forgiven and become children of God. What a present. Far better than even a John Deere. Certainly better than all these toys that we see. That we become children of God, members of God's family. What a blessing. What a gift at this time of year to celebrate. Let's pray together as we thank God for his gift of Jesus. Father, we do thank you today once again for Jesus. We thank you for this wonderful gift that you have sent us at this time of year. Lord, as the song says, all we need. It's all we need. Not just at this time of year, but for all of life, is to know your love in our hearts and respond to that love and become members of your family. Lord, as we go with our families today, as we go to celebrate the wonder of Christmas, as we go to play with toys and all the rest of it, as we enjoy those celebrations, help us to keep you central to it all. Lord, will you just go with each of us, bless us, we pray, for we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. We're going to close. We opened unannounced, I suppose, at the start, singing Joy Had Dawned. We started with joy, so we're going to end with joy. Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth receive her King. Let's celebrate Jesus coming to this earth. This is going to be a really silly statement I'm going to make now, but I was going to say I've been completely un-Presbyterian, but I mean, it doesn't get much more un-Presbyterian than this, but imagine I forgot about the offering. That makes that sound really bad, that at the heart of Presbyterianism is money, isn't it? But it's not really. I suppose in my head, Christmas Day, we don't normally lift an offering, but it is a Sunday, of course, and it is the last Sunday, as George said, to put the offering in for the end of the year. So the plates are at the doors, so you're not allowed out until you put money in them, all right? It's been that funny, I suppose, as I said, there's lots of things we're doing this year that we haven't been able to do for a couple of years, so I keep forgetting about these things, but it's there, and if you want to go that way there, Santa's there with a box of sweets as well. So if you want to see a big Santa with sweets, it's out that way there. But listen, let's pray as we close. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this time of joy, of celebration. We thank you for this time to focus on you, Lord, to start our Christmas day on the right foot. And Lord, we pray that you would part us now with your blessing. May the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit go with each of us, both now and forevermore. Amen. Amen.